What I want to do is put some dimensions in the drawing. There's a couple of ways I can do this. You notice that if I pick a wall, I see the temporary dimensions. If I click on the little dimension symbol beside the temporary dimension, it becomes a permanent dimension. And then if I click on the witness line and I click on the control that's on that witness line, I can change the point to which it's measuring till it shows the outside face, and then click one more time to finish it. The other way would be on the annotation tab. I could pick aligned, and if I hold tab while I'm hovering over the wall, I can select the outside face and then place my dimension. If I look at this in 3D, and there's a couple of ways I could do this. I could go to the quick access toolbar and click on the 3D view, or I could go under the project browser and click on 3D view. And I've got a way of managing the connections for the top and bottom of the walls. So if I pick a wall, you see that what I can do is on the properties palette, where I see the base is the floor level, and I go to the top constraint, and I can click in here and say, well, the top constraint would be the roof, and apply. And I could also tab while I'm hovering over a wall to select any connecting walls in addition to the one I was hovering over, and then click to accept them all. It might not be very clear, but under the top constraint now, I don't see the drop arrow, but if I click in it, I see the drop arrow, and then I can go and say I want all of them to go to the roof level. And if I click on undo, just so I go back, the other way of doing this would be if I looked in, say, the south view, and I'm looking at these individual walls, I could also select on a wall and drag the top down until it aligns with the level, and then apply the lock. So I could do it this way, where I drag down and lock, and drag down and lock. And if I go back to 3D, this is what my building looks like.